Good morning, children. I hope everyone are fine, right? So, in the last class, we completed second chapter, right? So, now we are going to discuss about the third chapter. We'll give an introduction about the coordinate geometry, okay? So, third chapter, we'll begin the third chapter today, that is coordinate geometry. Coordinate geometry. Here I'll give an introduction about everything. Okay, so that is nothing but means whatever the things, whatever the coordinate geometry, whatever the definitions are there, all those things I'll give an introduction today. Okay, so first one is they given introduction. You have already studied how to locate a point on a number line. You know how to locate a point on a number line, right? So you also know how to describe the position of a point on the number line, and there are many other situations in which to find the point we are required to describe its position with a reference to more than one line. For example, consider the following situations. There is a main road running in a east and west direction and streets with the numbering from a west to east. Okay, so that also on each street house numbers are marked. To look for a friend's house here, is it enough to know only one reference point? See here, you are going to your friend home. Okay, so on that road there will be a many streets are there. Street means only anta heli karidare hauda. See here, like this and like this. Okay, both the axis opposite sides both must be a one streets are there, right? So whether there is only one reference point is enough, only one reference point is enough to find that directions? No, we use a so many reference points. This reference point is nothing but a using a only one point. See here, this is a number like this, you say this is a 2. This is a only one reference point we used on the number line, right? But here to find the directions, we can't use a only one reference point. There will be a many reference points are there to find the directions, okay? So for that reason we use the coordinate geometry. Okay, so why, and again wait, after that one great mathematician is there, his name is René Descartes. René Descartes, the great French mathematician of the 17th century, liked to lie in a bed and think. One day when resting in a bed, he solved the problem of describing the position of a point in a plane. Okay, so his method was a development of the older idea of a latitude and longitude. In honor of a Descartes, the system used for describing the position of a point in a plane is also known as the Cartesian system. Okay, for his name, that is called as the Cartesian system. Okay, he described that the position of the point in a plane, that's why that point is called as the Cartesian plane. Why the Cartesian is here, that is a side. Mathematician name is René Descartes. Okay, they use the last words, that is the Cartesian. Cartesian point. Okay, using his name, that given that one as a Cartesian point. Okay, so after that the given is here on exercise number 3.1. How will you describe the position of the table lamp on your study table to the another person? Okay, you have to explain that position of the table lamp on your study table to another person. See here, I am another person for you, right? So I am sitting in front of you, and in your table, on your table, you are having one study lamp. You have to say that the position of the like that study lamp, you have to say to me. How we will describe that position of that lamp? Here the given C, for that given an example. See here, suppose you put a dot on a sheet of a paper. See here, this is our single sheet of a paper. Take any sheet of a paper, I'll put a dot on that. This is our dot. Okay, what is the position of that point? We have to describe that position of the point now. Okay, so for that you have to tell, if we ask to tell a position of dot on the paper, then you, how will you say this? Perhaps you will write in such a manner that the dot is in the upper half of the paper and it is near to the left edge of the paper. It is very near left hand upper corner of the sheet. Do any of these statements fix position of the dot precisely? No, but if you say the dot are nearly 5 cm away from the left edge of the paper and left to give some idea, but it does not fix the position of the dot, the little thought might enable you to say that the dot is also distance of 9 cm above the bottom lies. So we now exactly where the dot. So for this purpose, we fix the position of the dot by specifying the its distances from two fixed lines on the left edge of the paper and the bottom of the line paper. Other words, we need two independent information for finding the position of the dot. So perform following classroom activity as in a seating plan. Okay, like that we have to see here. This is a one sheet of paper. What they given, I'll explain here. Okay, so this is a consider. This is a one sheet of paper. Okay, I put a dot on that. Here I put a dot in here, right? So now how to describe the position of the that point? How to describe the position of the point here? Position of this point means, see here, the position of this point means how to describe position of the point. See, we can say it is nearer to the left edge. This is the left edge. This is the right edge, right? So this is a left edge. This is a right one, right? Right edge and left edge, and this is a top, this is a bottom. I hope everyone know this is a top and this is a bottom. Then this dot is nearer to the top, right? This dot is nearer to the top, and this dot is nearer to the left edge, right? It is nearer to left edge compared to right edge, right? We can say, we can describe like that, okay? Otherwise, you can measure these things using a scale. Measure this distance here. This will be a some 7 cm and this will be a some 1 cm. Okay? Then you can say the dot is 1 cm. It is the distance between the left edge to this or dot is 1 cm. And it is and the dot is 7 cm above the bottom. 7 cm above the bottom. The dot is lies here. Okay. Like that also you have to explain the position of the dot. Like that same, in the same way, draw one table. Okay. So, okay, this is a one table and here will be a study lamp. Okay, so here will be study lamp. You have to say the position of the study lamp to anyone, to another person. They said here, take anyone and how to explain the position of the study lamp on the table. Then what you can say, you can measure this distance. Okay, so it is a middle of the table, or it is a left side of the table, or it's a right side of the table, whatever. Okay, 2-3 lines you have to explain the position of the what? Study lamp. That is the thing. Okay? You only explain it is very easy one. Whether the position of the study lamp, you have to explain. Explain in your own sentences. Because you are in a 9th standard, right? You have to explain here. Okay? So, next question is, a city has a two main roads which cross each other at the center of the city. These two roads are along the north-south direction and east-west direction. So all other streets of the city are run parallel to these roads and are 200 meter apart. Then 5 streets in a direction using a 1 cm is equal to 200 meter. Draw a model of a city on your notebook. Represent the roads and streets by a single lines. How many cross streets can be referred as which? So draw the lines here. Second question answer and this is a west and east direction and this is a north south, north south east west. They given a street like this and you have to draw the street one. This is a street 1, street 2, street 3, street 4, street 5. Street 1, street 3, and here street 4, street 5. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, here also write the name, street 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, okay. So these are the streets, what they told here in the question, observe question properly, what they given, all other city has a two main routes, that two main routes are north and south and west and east, okay. This direction and this one. See here, west and east and north and south. This is west and east and north and south. These are the two main roads. Two main roads in the city. These are the two main roads in the city. Okay, these are the two main roads in the city. After that, they given which cross each other at the center of the city. This is called as the center of the city here. Which crosses both roads at the center of the city. This is the center of the city here now. This is the center of the city. Okay. So after that, these two roads are along the north-south direction and the east-west direction. One was the about the east-west direction and one about the north-south direction. After that, they given here question. Question is a very lengthy question, only there will be more than half page is there. Don't worry about that. Just read properly, you will understand. Okay. All the other streets of the city run parallel to these roads and are 200 meter apart. Okay. So there are 5 streets in each direction. In this direction also 5 streets and in this direction also 5 streets. They told in each direction there will be a 5 streets, means in east west direction also 5 streets and in north south direction also 5 streets are there. Okay, and they will consider that 1 centimeter equal to 200 meter. You have to consider here 1 centimeter. This is a 1 centimeter length. You have to consider this one as a 200 meter. Draw a model of the city on your notebook that represents the roads or a street. These are the called as the roads or a street. This represent the roads or a streets on the city. Okay. And there are many cross streets in your model. A particular cross street is made by a two streets. One running in the north-south direction and another one in the east-west direction. Right. So each cross street is referred to in the following manner. That is, if second street direction running in the north-south direction and fifth in the east-west direction meet some crossing, then we will call this street as a 2,5. Okay, so that is north south direction we have to consider first. Okay, this is second one and here this point is called as the 2,5. This point is called as the 2,5, and after that how many cross streets can be referred to as a 4, 3. Here 4 is here, right? 4. Take 4 and 3. 3 means street key. You have to take 4, 3. Okay? So consider. First number you have to consider is the this only. That is a east-west direction you have to consider. First number you have to consider here. That is a here 4 is there, right? They given a 4. In that first question and second question they given. So locate that point on this streets. That is a here 4 is there. And after that street 3. Where is street 3? Here. Here. Right? Street 3. So this point is considered as the 4, 3. Okay. Next one is 3, 4. Then first we have to consider a 3. Next after that street 4. This one is a 3, 4. I hope everyone know. First point you have to know on, you have to observe on the east-west direction. Second point on the north-west direction. Okay, this is a 3 and 4, 3, 4. And here 4 is there and this one is 3. So this point is the 4, 3. Like that we have to locate on the point. Locate on the this model. Okay, so 3.1 finished. Next one is a Cartesian system is there. What do you mean by Cartesian system? We will see now. In a Cartesian system, there will be a x-axis and y-axis are there. I hope everyone heard the name of x-axis and y-axis here. Yeah. Okay, Cartesian system means you have studied the number line in the chapter on a number system, right? You already studied the number line on a chapter, that first chapter, that is a number system, right? So on the number line, distance from a fixed point are marked in a equal units positively in a one direction and negatively in a another direction, right? So on number line, we are having a both positive numbers as well as the negative numbers, like that they are telling here. The point from which the distance are marked is called as the origin. Obviously, that middle point is called as the origin. That is nothing but a zero. Zero is called as the origin, right? So they told like that only here. We use the number line to represent the numbers by marking the points on the line at equal distances. If one unit distance represents the number 1, then 3 unit distance represent the number 3. Okay, so 0 being at the origin, the point in a position direction at a distance r from the origin represent the number r. Okay, so whatever the number is, just that is the position of that number, right? So the point in the negative direction at a distance r from the origin represents the number, and r location of a different numbers on the number line are shown in the figure. It is 3.5, sorry. And after that, they given a number line. It is a 1 unit distance and 1 unit distance. That is a middle number is the origin is there. Okay. So, next one is a this. They given combine both lines and in such a way that the two lines cross each other at zeros and zeros. Okay. Leave about all this one. I give directly Cartesian system. What are the Cartesian system and how to put a how to locate that numbers on a Cartesian system and what are the things are there in a Cartesian system. I'll explain everything. Okay. So now we'll see the Cartesian system. Okay, Cartesian system. Cartesian system. In that we are having a two axes here. First, this is called as here x dash and here x and y dash and middle value is here 0. Okay, so see here this is the x and x dash axis. Okay, this is called as, this line is called as the x dash h axis, and this one is called as the y y dash axis. Okay, so this is the x axis here. Origin is O here. This is the origin. Okay. This is the origin and left side, sorry, right side of this origin. This right side of the origin is called as the x-axis and left side of the origin is called as the x-dash. Okay, the left side of the origin is called as the x-dash and the right side of the origin is called as the x-axis and the upside, that is above the origin is called as the y-axis and below the origin is called as the y-dash axis. This is the x-axis, this is the x-dash axis, this one is the y-axis and y-dash axis. This is the Cartesian system here. This is called as the Cartesian system. Okay, because we locate here only 2D, two-dimensional values only we can locate here. We can't locate the three-dimensional values here. Okay. Only we can assume this x axis and y axis in only two dimensions. This is called as a 2D. That's why it's called as the Cartesian system. This is a Cartesian system. 3D, another one is that is nothing but a plane it is. Okay. So here, this is a Cartesian system, means x and x dash axis and y and y dash axis. In x axis, all the numbers are positive. Okay, in x axis all the numbers are positive. See, number line only. It is also number line. It is also number line. We are joining the two number lines here. That's it. Okay, you already learned number line, right? One side is right side of the zero is all are the positive numbers and left side of the zero is all are negative numbers. You know already that one. So we are joining the two number lines here. That is the thing. And the middle coincident, that point is called as the origin O. And right side of this means this is called as the x-axis. And x-axis containing only positive numbers. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. It is. Okay. This arrow mark means it is an infinity numbers. And here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. All are negative numbers here. In this side, all are the negative numbers. And above the origin, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, in y axis also all numbers are positive. And in y dash containing all the negative numbers. Okay, so minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, all are the negative numbers in the y dash axis. In x dash also negative numbers. This dash means you have to remember that there will be a negative points are there. Okay, in x axis positive values. In x dash, negative values. In y axis, all the positive values. In y dash, all are the negative values. This is the Cartesian system. Okay. So, after that, and this is called as the x axis, this is called as the y axis. See here, this is a quadrant 1. This is the quadrant 1, this is the quadrant 2, and this is the quadrant 3, and this one is the quadrant 4. Okay, so this part is called as the quadrant 1, this part is called as the quadrant 2, and this part is called as the quadrant 3, and this part is called as the quadrant 4. This is the first part, second part, third part, fourth part. See here, in first quadrant, all the values are positive because x-axis is also positive and y-axis is also positive. Okay. So, in quadrant 1, that both the values are. Means x-axis is also positive and y-axis is also positive. In first quadrant, all numbers are positive. Keep it in your mind. In second quadrant, see, x-axis are negative numbers and y-axis are positive numbers. Means here, in second quadrant, one is negative and another one is a positive, mainly. Okay, so in first quadrant both are the positive and in second quadrant x axis is negative and y axis is positive. First, always you have to write the x axis value. First number in the coordinates, you have to write the first number is always x axis. The number which is on the x axis, no, that you have to write here first. Okay. Next one, third quadrant means x axis negative and y axis is also negative. Here in third quadrant both are negative. And in fourth quadrant, x axis is positive and y axis is negative. Okay, remember the signs. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. You have to remember all the signs here. Okay, so here both are positive, here one negative, and another one is a positive, and here both are negative, and here one positive, one negative. Getting? Okay, fine. So next one is, coordinates of this D point. Coordinates means coordinates of a D. How to write the coordinates of D? That is nothing but the position of the D we have to say in the numbers. Like this only. See, D is on the x axis, it is a 0, right? On the 0 line, it is having. Okay, and in y axis, number is 2. Then 0, 2. Okay, the D coordinates of D are 0, D. Okay, if I locate on this here, this is as a E. Coordinates of E. Coordinates of E is x axis means 2 is there, and y axis means minus 1 is there. So E is equal to 2, minus 1. Like that we have to write. This is called as the coordinates of the that point. These are called as the coordinates of that point. Okay. So, I hope everyone understood this Cartesian system as well as what is the coordinate geometry and how to locate that one, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and what are the x-axis and what are the y-axis. All those things I hope everyone understood. Okay. Next, we'll continue in the next class. Till that, be safe in your home. Thank you everyone.